know, life suddenly sometimes puts you on the spot.
Penalty kick! Referee, clear-cut penalty.
It's closing time. You're either heading home alone, or you're going for glory.
Have a pop, son. See if you can.
Take it from me. Read the small print first.
Dad, got to go. Have a nice day.
It's not so much that you might get hurt. It's more that you're liable to make a complete arse of yourself. You either find the courage to face up to it, or you sneak away back into the shadows. Personally, I think sneaking is safer.
On your way, Stuart.
Shadowing?
Yeah, I want to follow one of your reporters for the day. I need to get an idea of how each department works. That includes sport.
Well, you could trail Val, I suppose.
Sports is such a male-dominated environment. I'm sure Valerie has enough trouble being accepted without having me around to make things even harder for her.
Well, I mean, that only leaves Stuart or...
Forbes.
Forbes. Stuart.
Okay, then. Tell him I'll be joining him today.
Yeah, the thing is, I'm not sure he's even here this morning. He's been covering a lot of away games. I haven't seen much of him all week.
Ewan, I saw him coming in.
Did you? Huh? Well, he must be here then. Right, I'll go and tell him. Good news.
But I can't. It's... Well, she's management. What am I going to say to her?
I don't know, Stuart. You're just going to have to think of something.
Why me?
Because... She thought you'd be the best one to take her.
What about Val?
Why should I get landed with her?
That could be cosy, hen. You could swap recipes and that.
At least you see some work get done.
I wouldn't mind showing the lassie the ropes, if you want.
Tell her I'm not in.
Stuart, you have to do it.
And you better be careful what you say to her.
Yeah, don't give too much away.
See if you can find out anything. But keep your distance. She'll act the innocent, but we all know what she's after. She's looking for an excuse to fire people.
Yeah, so for Christ's sake, don't give her one.
Fine.
You seem a bit uncomfortable.
Oh, no, it's an old sports injury.
I mean about me being here.
Oh. I'm just used to working on my own, I suppose.
No, I mean about me being here.
Oh.
Oh, for God's sake, Stuart, just going to tell me what the problem is. What are you so afraid of that you're having to avoid me?
Who says I'm avoiding you?
I saw you crawling around the car park this morning.
Oh.
Never mind. Oh. Look, we had fantastic sex and I redecorated your kitchen. But in some tribes that would make us man and wife. I thought we could at least be friends.
Yeah, but it's not that easy.
Why not? Are you embarrassed about what happened?
No. I thought you were the new girl in Features. Turns out you're the hotshot management expert sent here to decide our fate.
Are you honestly telling me that if you'd known who I was, well, nothing would have happened the other night?
It's not about you. It's about me.
Fair enough. But does it mean you have to go and treat me like Typhoid Mary?
No. No, you're right. I'm sorry.
It doesn't exactly boost a girl's confidence now, does it?
I wouldn't have thought you...
This has changed.
You used to come?
My dad took me a few times when I was wee.
You enjoy it?
Yeah. I was pretty young, but I remember the noise. There are a lot of goals and songs. Oh, and some dreadful haircuts.
Not changed much then.
So he's a new player?
No, he's been here 2 years.
So what's he signing?
A new contract.
Oh, he's been transferred?
No, he's staying here.
So he's been here 2 years and he's not going anywhere?
Yeah.
And that's news?
That's football.
Time for a few questions. Stuart.
Tommy, how do you feel now, having committed to another 2 years here after there being so much speculation about a possible move away?
I'm very happy everything's been sorted out. Very happy.
Uh-huh. Do you feel the combination of such a large club in such an exciting city made it difficult to contemplate leaving?
Yeah, definitely. That's right. Exactly.
Looking forward to even greater success in the next few seasons.
Absolutely am. That's what I'm looking forward to.
Thanks, Tommy.
Howard?
Tommy, have you anything to say about the allegation?
Is that it?
We've got enough. Statement from the club, a few choice words from the man himself. If they get the photograph back quick, they can get it in the second edition.
Now, the choice words were more to do with you.
He's a footballer, not a politician. I just helped him out a bit. His mum will read the paper tonight and be proud of how eloquent he was. Do you want to deny her that moment of simple maternal joy, eh? Could you live with that in your conscience? Aye, did you put the copy boy on? Uh-huh. The youngster Tommy Hannan expressed with touching simplicity.
East End to West End. We're covering the city today. This is my old stomping ground.
Yeah?
I used to play in those.
You've still got 10 minutes. Taking you back?
Yeah. Oh, it looked a bit different in my day.
Couldn't have been that long ago.
Oh, 16, 17 years ago. Oh, I broke my collarbone here. And my heart. Had my first kiss, my first cigarette, and my last. I scratched my name in that tree over there. And drank cider on that bench.
I had you down as a good Catholic girl.
Oh, I was. You should have seen what the bad girls were up to.
I dread to think.
Marty Maguire did things behind that pavilion in 5th year that I still haven't done. We lived on the other side of the university, so this was a safe place to talk to boys. Out of sight of my parents.
They still live around here?
Up in Hindland.
Oh, very nice.
I suppose you've always been south side.
Afraid so. I get panic attacks if I go down the buyer's road. All those delicatessens, it's too much for me. I have to go and calm down in a betting shop or something.
Sure, it's not that different over your way.
Oh, it is. Until I was 25, I thought Tarama Salata was a Turkish second division site. It must be nice to be back.
You know, a lot's changed.
Still the same place.
Is it?
I bet your name's still written on that tree.
Nah. I've grown out of it.
Like you've grown out of talking to boys in the park.
Your interviewing technique is excellent. Now, I think maybe we should go so you can use it on this football player.
Is this where we're going?
Is there a problem?
No. No problem.
Cara!
Hey! This is my sister, Jess.
Oh, hi. Stuart.
Oh, Stuart! Never leaves London these days, Stuart. Forgotten about the rest of us up here. High-flying career girl. No time anymore for a poor wee sister. And then suddenly here we are, and I can't...
Jess, this is business.
Oh, right. Well, I'll leave you to it then.
Small world.
Small town. Oh, I think this is your footballer.
Paolo, thanks for coming. Appreciate it.
My pleasure.
This is my colleague, Cara.
Buongiorno, Cara.
Come sta?
Bene, grazie.
Si?
I recognise the footballer. Who's the other guy?
Stuart, from the paper.
What, the Stuart? The one she...
Must be.
What's he like?
He's nice. Well, he was winding her up.
Brave man, winding up your sister.
What, you say my sister's scary?
Not as scary as you.
Oh, come here.
Sì, ma è stata a Firenze.
Sì.
Sì. Adesso ho comprato una grossa villa a Firenze. Potremmo passare un bel fine settimana assieme. Uh-huh. Potremmo bere del vino, del Chianti, andare a mangiare una bruschetta assieme. Mm. Sai, un fine settimana bellissimo.
Paolo, do you feel the fans have warmed you over the course of the season?
The fans are wonderful. I've taken them to my heart, and I hope they've taken me to theirs.
They didn't seem so sure about you before Christmas.
See, every relationship has difficulties on the road. Otherwise, there would be no interest in it. Sono quei piccoli capricci a rendere una storia d'amore più appassionante.
Capito. He says that it is only in the struggles of love that true passion can be discovered.
Right.
Do you not agree?
Yeah, I suppose so.
I think it's very true.
You are obviously a woman of some experience in these things, Cara.
I am a woman of some experience in many things.
Mi piacerebbe conoscerle.
Do you think that your better form has to do with you now playing in your strongest position?
I like to think I'm comfortable in any position. So, arrivederci.
Yeah.
And we'll meet again, I'm sure.
I look forward to it.
She made a hair appointment, eh? Not your type.
No. Though it's not often you meet a man who can be that salacious in two languages. Was the interview all right?
Yeah, I think I got enough in between the come-ons. Thanks for the translations.
Oh, I'm a bit rusty. I usually only use it with my family.
And you're not back home very often?
No.
So have you been in London long?
About 10 years.
Lured at the bright lights?
Something like that. The lure of a bright boy, too.
Was he worth it?
You know what they say. It's only in the struggles of love that true passion can be discovered. Back to the office?
There's something I need to do first. Maybe I could call you a cab and I'll meet you back there.
I'm your shadow. Where you go, I go.
Ah.
So where are we off to?
All right, Shorty.
Hi, Dad. Hi, Cara.
Hello there.
No. boing, 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 boing,
boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing,
boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing,
boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing,
boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing, boing. This isn't an amusement arcade.
I'm sorry about this.
What?
It's just lunch took so long. I'm normally finished by this time, then I go and pick him up, but today...
Well, have I been slowing you down?
Well, things just stretched out a bit, I suppose.
And now you're having to work fast.
Tyranny of the deadline. You always have to work fast.
Oh, I mean, that's the skill, of course. You know, I mean, not everyone can write quickly and still maintain the quality.
Hmm. Must be difficult.
Pretty straightforward, really.
Don't you listen to him. A tartan Tom Wolfe, that's who he is. A Scottish Hugh McIlvany.
Hugh McIlvany is Scottish.
Yeah, but you know what I mean. I mean, we like to keep things informal here, but it doesn't affect our efficiency.
Right then. Done. Dennis, we're going.
Dad, I've just got to...
Now. Leave my hard-working colleagues in peace.
You're too kind.
I'll see you tomorrow. 2:30, press entrance. If you still want to see how we cover a game.
Yeah, I do.
Right. Good.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Yeah. Yeah, tomorrow.
And thanks.
For what?
Today. I enjoyed it.
Yeah. Yeah, that was all right, wasn't it?
Dad!
Gotta go.
Good day?
Yeah. Very interesting.
Do you always do this? The shadowing?
Usually. We've got to know exactly how things stand before we can start to suggest improvements.
So how do things stand with Stuart then?
Much as expected.
Planning any improvements?
Mel, I'm here for a fixed time to perform a specific task. Everything else is secondary.
Everything?
Everything.
Hello, boys.
Kirsty.
What are you two up to then?
Friday night. Burger night.
Oh, fantastic.
Want to come?
Oh, I'd love to, sweetheart, but I've got something on.
You're looking gorgeous. Have you got a date?
Well, I wouldn't call it a date exactly.
So, who's the lucky girl?
Me, hopefully.
He was nice. We liked him. And so do you, I can tell.
Don't start. Nothing is going to happen.
Nothing else, you mean? Don't forget your first little adventure.
Oh, God. I wish I could.
Oh, come on, don't sweat it. It's obviously not put him off.
What do you mean?
I mean he still fancies the pants off you.
Oh.
Oh, yes.
Why is it called a Happy Meal?
Because it's supposed to make you happy.
So why didn't you have one?
Well, it's for kids. It's not for grown-ups.
Why aren't grown-ups allowed to be happy?
We are.
Are you happy?
I'm happy with you. Because they like the sunshine.
So why do they come back here in the summer?
Because this is their home.
Ah!
I'm gonna get you. Catch you.
I have to warn you, the gentlemen of the press here really aren't very gentlemen. They're not used to having women around.
That's all right. I'm used to men who aren't used to that.
Yeah, but some of these guys are international class chauvinists. They could show for Scotland.
Hey, I'm a big girl. I can handle it.
They've got a motto.
What's that?
Nae birds.
Hey, Stuart, you have to pay more for a snogging seat.
I think she'll change the ends at half time.
If I throw a stick, will you disappear?
I suppose the shark's out of the question, eh?
Cowden Beath have got more chance of scoring than you have.
Howard. Howard. This is Cara. She's working at the post.
Birds.
Eat your pie. What do you think?
Good. The game's not brilliant, but it's an amazing atmosphere.
Yeah.
Oh!
You always get this excited.
It's a passionate game.
What happens now?
I'll do the report tonight, send it in tomorrow. It'll be in the first edition on Monday.
Well, what about the other games?
Well, Val will be with Rangers, Ewan's at Firhill, Forbes is up in Dundee. We have to make sure we cover the Glasgow teams first. Other games we can use stringers or press association reports.
What about the other sports?
What other sports? No, we can take results and reports from the PA.
But you only cover football?
I'm a specialist. Like you. So what about your report? What are you going to say?
Just what I've seen.
No conclusion?
Not yet. Analysis first, then action.
You're going to be laying people off?
Only if there's no other way.
You must have to make some hard decisions.
That's my speciality. Does that make me scary?
Makes you dangerous.
Isn't that the same thing?
No. More dangerous is better.
Oh, I've got to go out tonight.
You don't sound very enthusiastic.
It's a family thing.
I know the feeling.
Well, thanks again.
Have a nice time.
No, I won't, but thanks anyway. Oh, in Italy, they do this. Ciao.
See ya.
Game, Stuart?
Yeah, it was all right. Got going eventually.
Do you remember that, Alex?
What's that?
The barbecue we had that summer, when Dennis was just a baby. What a heat there was that day.
Didn't get much use out of the Barbie last year, did you, Alex?
No, never had the weather for it.
Siobhan looked lovely in that blue dress, didn't she? I remember when we bought it. I was with her up in town. She didn't want to get it. Thought she hadn't got her figure back after having the baby. I told her not to be daft. I was right. She looks stunning, doesn't she? Doesn't she, Stuart?
Yeah, she does.
I think that dress was my favourite.
Yes, look at that, Moira. Dennis has finished his jigsaw.
Oh, clever boy. Well done.
Can I go and play in my room now?
Go on then.
Every day gets to look more like her.
I was reading about the paper getting bought over, Stuart. That'll mean a few changes.
Yeah, there's some kind of reorganisation planned.
You think jobs will go.
You're not going to get laid off, are you?
Oh, they can't tax him. He's their best football man.
If they own it, they can do what they like.
Well, they're compiling some new strategy document. No one knows what's going to happen.
That would be a disaster, Stuart. An absolute disaster. I mean, you're managing to cope now, but if you lost your job...
It's not going to happen, Moira.
But you just said no one knows. Now, we know it's difficult for you. But it's been difficult for us two having to stand by and watch you struggle like this.
Struggle?
And even though we agreed how things would be, well, if circumstances change, we have to sit down and rethink the whole situation. We have to think of Dennis.
Dennis is fine.
But if you lose your job...
I'm not going to lose my job, Moira.
Moira, leave it.
I'm only saying...
I've just remembered. I forgot to give Kirsty a message. I'll be back in a minute.
What?
Who is it?
Bloody woman.
Moira.
Every time she comes round, she moons over the photo album and goes on about Dennis having Siobhan's eyes. As if I don't know that. As if I need reminding. As if I don't see that every single day. It's like she's dictating a grief to you, tear by tear by tear. It's like a water torture. I can't take it anymore. I can't. I've got my own grief to play with. I don't need anyone else's. And now she's on about Dennis not being brought up properly. Like I'm sending him to school barefoot or something, or not feeding him. As if not having a civil service index-linked automatic member of the golf club pension makes you some lower form of shitty life!
Are you done?
Yeah. Sorry.
It's post-figurative. Next door neighbour. He sometimes pops round for a chat. Ta-da!
Not with those boots.
But I want to wear my boots.
Well, go and find another dress.
Well, what are you wearing?
Dunno. I haven't thought about it.
Well, what have you been thinking about for the last half hour, then?
Nothing.
Cara, tell me.
There are going to be people there tonight that I haven't seen for years.
There's going to be people there tonight that I haven't seen for years, so?
I mean, since I left.
Oh, since the Simon thing?
Yeah, since the Simon thing.
People will have forgotten.
Darling daughter seduced by dreadful boy. He takes her away to live in the big, bad city.
Walks out now, a week before the wedding. Yeah, would you forget something like that? Well, when you put it like that.
It's tonight and the wedding. I know I'm going to be collecting a whole lifetime's worth of tut-tuts and I told you so's. I'll be pointing and whispering.
Sod them. Let them point, let them whisper. You're not going on your own. I'll be there, and Marissa. And Francesca's not going to have anyone slagging you off, so forget about it.
I wish it were that easy.
Listen, little black dress, 3-inch heels, a bottle of tequila, and it will be that easy. Come on, we're going to go out tonight and we're going to show them that the only reason Simon legged it is because he knew he just wasn't man enough to handle my big sister's amazing combination of beauty, brains and balls the size of watermelons.
Well, when you put it like that...
Oh, God, head night! I'd forgotten how torturous these things can be.
Oh, I quite like it. It's traditional, isn't it? I remember my head night.
Is it that?
I don't remember you snogging any strange men for a pound of gold. Well, unless you count your George.
Cara, don't be disgusting.
Me? You're the one that married him.
Stop it. I'm not having you slagging George. It's cruel.
Cruel? I'll tell you what's cruel. Naming your children Phoebe and Paloma and sending them to school in Glasgow. Now that is cruel.
Don't start that again. The children are perfectly happy. Why do you always have to attack what I have?
Because you always act as if everyone else should want the same.
Well, God forbid that you or Jess should want to be happy or content or secure like me.
There are other ways, Marissa.
But I don't see any of your ways working.
Don't you worry about me.
But I do, Cara. However old you get and however far away you go, I worry because you're my wee sister. And there's nothing you can do to change that.
I thought we were going to visit Uncle Ewan tomorrow.
I thought we'd turn up early and surprise him. Listen, Dennis, you know how it's just you and me now your mum's gone?
Uh-huh.
You don't feel you're missing out on anything, do you?
Like what?
Anything.
Anything. There is one thing.
Tell me.
A kite.
He worked for Dad one summer before he went off to university.
The specky guy with a mole?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
What?
He was disgusting.
Well, he was sweet.
You got off with Colin Kenry?
Yeah.
So what did you do then?
Oh, we kissed.
Tongues?
Oh, God, I'm going to be sick.
I don't even remember him.
Well, he was nice.
Well, what else then?
That was it, really. He was in the St. Vincent de Paul.
Just a snog, Marissa, doesn't count.
So there was really nobody before George then?
I'm not ashamed of that. And I don't think you're in any position to throw stones. At least I don't sleep with other people's husbands or fall into bed with a man without even knowing his name.
That was just once, by the way, just once.
That was uncalled for. Sorry.
Well, the point is, it'd be a strange old world if you were stuck with whoever popped your cherry, would you?
Popped your cherry?
I'd be with Raymond's from the video shop. He's in prison.
Well, better that than the...
What, who is he? Oh, my God, but you just slept with Dominic!
For heaven's sake, Marissa, keep it down, will you? Francesca's just over there.
Oh, does she know?
Not unless she just heard you bellowing it out.
Anyway, it was years ago.
Even so, how could you?
Oh, this is why I never told you before.
Time for more drink.
You could buy kites at a garage.
Buy anything in a garage these days. Some of them even sell petrol.
But why the urgent need for a kite?
Because he asked for it.
Oh, dangerous precedent. Fatal without her.
I was on a guilt trip.
About what?
Not being enough.
Very male guilt trip, that.
No, I mean not being enough of a parent. On my own.
You're not on your own. Do you think we stood up in church and renounced Satan and all his works just so we could have an easy life?
Aye, and bear in mind that Satan and all his works just about covered my entire range of interests.
Thought he was going to have to take up stamp collecting.
I admit, you've both been great godparents.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You know what I mean?
Cue male bonding pep talk, I think, Ewan.
I'm getting there. Don't rush me.
Go on.
Hold on. I've lost my thread now.
There's no such thing as a perfect parent.
Yeah, that'll do. You see, there's no such thing as a perfect parent. I mean, you can't be one. And anyway, who'd want to? Be a nightmare. I mean, you've got to remember that half the time, these wee buggers turn out pretty normal despite our best efforts, not because of them. Don't fret about it. You don't have to be perfect, Stuart. You just have to be good enough.
And believe me, you're plenty good enough, Stuart.
Yeah.
Yeah. So just shut up and give you some peace, right?
Right.
I don't know! If I
asked myself 1,000 times. I suppose I just wanted to try it and he was handy.
And was he?
What?
Handy.
Marissa!
It was shit. The first time's always shit. I mean, especially if it's their first time too. I mean, it takes a bit of practice. The first time's always crap.
Mine was fantastic, actually.
With George!
I thought we'd established that.
I meant
how?
Because it was very gentle and very caring and we loved each other. It's just got better and better ever since. Of course, well, you two have probably never noticed George's little secret, have you?
How's it look?
It's not how it looks. It's will it fly.
Dominic! What are you doing here?
Just keeping an eye on things.
I'm very protective of you. Francesca's just over there.
I know. But I've got the rest of my life with Francesca. How about a moment with you?
What?
You're looking fantastic.
I feel dreadful.
I could make you feel better.
Don't even think it.
Think
what?
It is not going to happen. Not now, not ever again.
Never, Shane, never again.
Please, don't do the Sean Connery thing.
Do you still like her? I remember when you used to come home for Christmas. Remember that Boxing Day? It wasn't all sherry and turkey sandwiches underneath the mistletoe.
Dominic, I was drunk. But I was desperate. It was the season of goodwill. I made a mistake.
Twice.
Okay, twice. But it is not going to happen again, ever.
Only diamonds are forever.
You're deaf.
Cara.
Listen, I'm seeing someone, all right? And he's the jealous type, and he's big. And he'll thump you if you keep this up.
Who?
Well, you don't know him.
Well, I expect I'll get to meet him at the wedding then, eh?
Probably. Well, just leave me alone.
Cara, wait. You know there's a special bond between us. You can't deny the power of our connection. Cara, look at me. Look me in the eye and tell me how you really feel about me. Go on, tell me.
Well, I'll do better than that, don't you? Come to rescue me, my knight in shining armour.
Are you pissed?
Excuse me a bit.
We'll make out your last, eh?
Oh, my hen knight. One of our mistakes is here tonight, and... Well, I'd just like to dedicate this song... to him. Go, Mama! I want to break free.
And all about you, Sonny Jim. Oh, yes.
What?
Do you know men like you make me
make me.
Make you what?
One-night stand. You let your hair down once in a blue moon, like what happens? No luck.
That was all right.
Anything going to come of it?
Be difficult. With her working at the paper. Wouldn't look very good, would it?
It's not how it'd look. It's whether it'd fly.
Doing with a drunken bum like him.
Having the time of my life.
So what are the odds in getting a cab then?
No chance!
So?
It's a nice enough night for it.
Aye, I suppose it is.
So?
So we walk.
What's George gonna say?
Nothing of any interest to anyone, ever.
I heard that, you.
Just you remember.
That's it. We've got it now. Floating up there. Hey, Dennis, got it? Come here now. In front of me, aye? Hold on to you. Got it? Keep it tight now.
Try and keep the line tight, Dennis.
That's it.
I still wonder if he wouldn't be better off with someone else around.
Stuart, stop it. If you start thinking like that, there's never going to be someone else. No woman is going to fall in love with Dennis and learn to like you just so they can mother him. It works the other way around. Get it? They have to fall for you first. And if you're out there dazzling every poor girl who shows the least bit of interest with your big searchlight, looking for the new Siobhan, you're going to be looking for a very, very long time. Ewan, I think we need a translation.
She thinks you should lighten up a bit, mate.
Thank you.
Easier said than done, though, isn't it?
Well, when you think about it, everything's easier said than done.
Photosynthesis?
Hurdling.
Flying a kite.
Very loud shirt. What are you doing?
I was just looking for something.
What?
Doesn't matter.
Oh, my head. What have you done to me? I've only been back a few weeks and I've aged 5 years.
You're glad to be back then, weren't you? I mean, even if it is just for a while.
But I don't think now is a good time to ask.
You certainly crammed a lot in already.
He's had his moments, I grant you.
Enough to make you think about staying longer or coming back properly.
You're getting profound in me on a Sunday morning, Jess. You might as well have gone to Mass.
But London of all places, I mean, New York, Paris, Rome I could understand, but London.
My life's down there now.
If that's the life you want.
Famous last words.
Another 3 feet and you've got it, Stuart.
Yeah, thanks, pal.
Cara?
What?
It's not your Stuart.
Where?
Over there. Oh. Falling out of that tree.
How'd it come down by the trunk?
It's Stuart, are you all right?
Hi.
Oh, hello.
Hi.
Cara, did you see Dad fall out of the tree?
Yeah, I did.
Great, wasn't it?
Spectacular.
God, I should have sold tickets. Come on.
You sure you're all right there, Icarus?
Bruised ego, I think.
Is that what you landed on?
Maybe he was trying to do bird impression.
Ah, yeah, I thought it looked like a penguin.
Ostrich.
Dodo.
All right, have you finished now?
Well, we're just warming up.
Enough.
There was a good Southside boy doing this far west anyway.
Came over to see this pair. I don't know why.
There's gratitude for you. We offer babysitting, board and lodging, counselling and literary criticism, all for the price of a bus across the river.
Literary criticism?
Franz Kafka here brings us his latest chapters and we tell if it's any good or not.
Are you writing a book?
Trying to.
What's it about?
Hey.
EM made us sign the unofficial secret sign.
Is it good?
He's definitely got something.
Broken ribs.
Have you fixed it, Dad?
Sorry, son. I think it's had it.
May I? Yeah,
feel free. I think I might have landed on it when I fell.
Yeah, I think maybe it wasn't assembled properly.
Excuse me.
We read the instructions.
Were they in Korean or something?
Is it fixed then?
Only one way to find out.
Well, I think the wind's a bit too gusty for it.
Oh, aye.
All right then. Come on, Dennis. Let's get this thing in the air.
Come on, Dad.
Okay, we got them tight. Okay,
what,
and
go! Yeah! Did she do that?
That's our Cara. Always the same. Even as a kid, she could never resist a lost cause.
No, there's an interesting quality to her.
That is brilliant.
Beginner's luck.